bad enough. But when you have on top of it, literally, a presidency that simply is making sure that hypocrisy and deception become the order of the day, this country is in trouble. We are doomed. And if you in the media, if others who have what you call voices of conscience continue to pretend that we cannot see, we cannot hear, and allowing this to continue, we are destroying this nation and our children are in trouble. Our children are in trouble. The soul of Ghana is at stake. This is not just about power. Our national anthem says we should have fearless honesty. That fearless honesty should enable us to fight oppressors' rule. That's the only way you can build a nation that is great and strong. You have seen what you call a catalog of lies. One district, one factory. Lies. What they've done is simply go back to the same factories, give them some incentive. You know, there's nothing wrong with accepting that, you know, I promise this, I simply can't do it. There's nothing wrong. But when you go into what you call the grand deception, to lie to people when everybody can see that what you are doing is not what you promise, that is destroying the very soul of a nation. One village, one dam. They come and tell you that, oh, do you expect us to be able to build dams with 250,000? Then why the deception? That's what you find systematically, all kinds of things. You say simply for power. And then when you say, oh, you promised was in a one-time premium, you didn't do it. So that's their justification. After all, we lost power. So if anything at all, the country has done what it's got to do. What about you? That rode on the high horse of incorruptibility. And you are actually doing far worse. And when they talk, you say, oh, because you promised you didn't do, it justifies my degeneration, my decadence, my corruption, my lies, my hypocrisy? No! So what it is we are coming to show you today is to establish to you that we have been in COVID. And all over the world, COVID has been called a global pandemic. But it's actually a bigger pandemic that confronts Ghana. It's a pandemic of deception that is ruling this nation. It's a plague of hypocrisy that is presiding over Ghana. Is the transformation of Ghana into a citadel of corruption and allow all the enablers to keep quiet while grave danger is going on. So what you're going to see today is again another systematic effort by our friends in the MPP to try to play a fast one over every one of you. You in the media should not enable it. You should not enable it. Some of the lies you are going to hear that, oh, this actually happened even before he became president, it's a lie. We're going to establish that. We'll establish that to you. Oh, this actually was just a donation. There was nothing wrong about it. It's a lie. And deep down, I'm sure many of you know. Deep down in the heart of President Akufo-Addo, he knows. I come from Nogokpo in the Volta region. And a few of you who know Nogokpo will know. You dare not lie. If President Akufo-Addo actually says he's a man, let him come with me to Nogokpo and see whether he can lie there. He will not. He will not. But because in the name of all these holy, holy, he can swear in the Bible and lie. Because there's no fear. But when it is that you know that you cannot escape, he will not be able to lie. And we'll be able to establish that to you, that all the things you are going to see, the maneuvers on the part of our friends in MPP to simply deceive you, is simply nothing but lies.